All right, so next speaker, Merve, she's going to talk about a surprising phenomenon where people are trying to steal money from mobile operators. So.
Thanks for the introduction. So my name is Merve. I'm a PhD student in Eurecom in France. I work with Professor Aurélien Francillon. And today I will present you our study on a recent type of telephony fraud, which is called over-the-top bypass. So over-the-top as a term is mostly used by telecom operators, and it refers to the online services that run on top of the operator, so the operator cannot control or cannot bill these services. And they basically substitute or compete with the traditional telecommunication services like voice calls, SMS, or broadcasting services, which are actually the profitable part of the telecommunications industry. So the over-the-top applications have a global presence through the smartphone application markets, and they have a very large user base. They actually, by 2018, 2 billion OTT messaging users are estimated. There are a few points that I want to mention about the over-the-top applications. So most of the time, they use your phone numbers to identify and authenticate their users. So you register the application using your phone number. And so all of these applications have different terms of use and privacy policies. And users usually don't read all these terms and policies, they just accept them. And finally, even though these over-the-top providers, even though they provide free communication, they still need to earn some revenue from their product. So what they can do several different marketing policy for that. But one way of monetizing the product is to interact with the telephone network. So on your mobile phone, you can either make a phone call, a regular phone call using your SIM card on the mobile network, or you can install an OTT application and make a voice over IP call, which will be free. So throughout the presentation, we will denote the OTT application with this picture, and for the mobile network, we will use a SIM card picture. So there are lots of legitimate ways of interacting between OTT and telephony. Basically, a normal OTT call is a free call most of the time. You just install the application and you can call. But also the OTT user can also use the OTT out service so that he can call a regular normal or a regular mobile or landline phone. But just by paying a small amount of fee. Also, the OTT user can receive calls from regular mobile or landline numbers. And in this case, basically, he will be getting some dedicated phone number from the OTT provider, and all the calls to this phone number will be rerouted to the OTT application. So these interactions are legitimate because first the users benefit from them. They pay, for example, instead of paying for international call, they pay just a local fee, but they can call a callee in another country. Also, this is legitimate because all the parties here, they are aware of how the call is being routed. So we don't have any problems with this kind of telephony interactions. So now, before explaining the OTT bypass, I will talk about how a normal international call works. So in a regular international call, there are multiple operators involved. Basically, the revenue of the call is shared among these operators. So there is the originating operator getting the revenue from the customer. He keeps a part of it, and he passes the rest of the amount to the next transit operator. Usually, there are multiple transit operators on the call route, but here, for simplification, I will just show one of them. So again, the transit operator keeps some part of the revenue, and finally, the terminating operator receives the international call termination fee. So the international call termination fee changes from country to country. Usually, the small countries and the developing countries, they have larger call termination fees, which makes them more profitable for OTT bypass. So in an OTT bypass call, what happens is basically there is a fraudulent operator on the call route, and this operator makes an agreement with an OTT provider. And if when there is a call, if the destination number of the phone, if the destination number is registered on the OTT network, and if the callee is currently online, then the call will be hijacked and terminated on the OTT application. So, what happens here? International call termination fee will not be paid to the destination country. Instead, this money will be shared between the bypassing operator and the OTT provider. So this becomes very profitable for the bypassing parties, whereas the terminating operator basically does not earn any money, or it loses all this incoming call traffic. So there are several consequences. First of all, for the caller and the originating operator, they will be paying for a premium quality, and they will be paying the real call termination fee, but their call will be hijacked, and potentially they will have quality problems. For the callee, also, callee will have quality problems. This is not just audio quality. Audio quality can be actually as better as a normal phone call, depending on your connection. But there are also some problems about mobility if you switch between data network and Wi-Fi network, etc. In most of the world, the callee doesn't pay any money to receive a call, but when there is OTT bypass, he may pay for the data usage, and he won't be able to use the telco services like voicemail or call forwarding. So here it is very important to note that callee can actually prevent OTT bypass, because OTT bypass is usually enabled, is just an option on your application. You can disable it, but most of the time, because it is hidden inside the default settings and it is enabled by default, and because the users doesn't really read the terms of use, they are not aware that they are allowing OTT bypass. So the worst consequence will be to the terminating party, the bypass operator, because he will lose a lot of revenue, he will lose a lot of incoming call traffic, and he will probably suffer from customer dissatisfaction. So in addition to all of these effects, there are also other reasons why we say that OTT bypass is a fraud. Basically, there are a lot of regulations violated. First, there are the regulations that indicate that the call routing should be performed based on the phone number allocation is violated, because the phone number is actually allocated to the operator, but the terminator of the call is the OTT provider. Also, the service level agreements between operators that are violated, and these agreements usually say that, okay, there should be a certain quality on the service, but that quality may not be met. Finally, of course, the bypassing parties will be avoiding the regulatory fees and taxes, which consist a part of the international call revenue. The estimated annual loss of OTT bypass is tens of millions of dollars per victim operator. And recently, ITU formed a working group to study OTT bypass, where they actually state that this is a fraud. So if we look at it in a larger landscape of telecom fraud, the OTT bypass is not the only method of bypassing the calls over IP network. There are several other techniques. We have actually a SOC paper on telecom fraud where we detailly analyze all this kind of different telecom fraud and different bypass techniques. So some examples can be PBX abuse or SIMBAX fraud. I won't go into the details of PBX, but I want to quickly quickly say what a SIMBAX is. So a SIMBAX is a device that contains multiple SIM cards inside, and they act as a gateway between the IP network and the GSM network. So when after a fraudulent operator bypasses the call over the IP network, he actually re-injects the call into the telephony network using the SIM cards. So bypass fraud in general, it is very experienced a lot in telecommunications, and the total global estimated loss of bypass fraud is almost $6 billion. Was $6 billion in 2015. There are some previous work on the detection of SIMBAX fraud, basically either by identifying the SIM cards or the SIMBAX devices, or by identifying some call audio features of the SIMBAX bypass calls. But those ideas do not really apply to OTT bypass. So what would be the solution? Of course, before deploying any solution, you need to detect if you have bypass on your network. Then for the operators, it is important to measure the scale and the financial impacts of the OTT bypass. And finally, you will need to prevent it, but most of the time, the prevention techniques actually depends on the detection. So in this work, we focus on detection and measurement, and we leave the prevention for future work. So there are several challenges to detecting and measuring OTT bypass. First of all, from the point of view of the originating operator, it is very hard to see if an outgoing call was bypassed, because the originating operator doesn't have visibility on the complete call route. So he is only able to see one step ahead, his next hop. Also, for the point of view of the terminating operator, it is very hard to see if the incoming calls are bypassed, because the operator will not have any call logs, any visibility on the bypassed call volume. So we actually discuss all possible different techniques that can be used to detect OTT bypass. For example, one of them could be for the terminating the bypassed operator. It could be to observe the decrease in the call volume, and if there is a very high decrease, it may be related to OTT bypass. But this is not very reliable, because it can also be related to another reason, like a normal OTT usage. Also, the terminating the bypassed operator maybe can analyze his network traffic and see if he can find any OTT bypass traffic. This is good, because if you detect the OTT bypass traffic on your network, then you can block it. But it is not a complete solution, because the calls may go over other type of IP networks. And it is not definitive, because in practice, or like in theory, the OTT a normal OTT call and an OTT bypass call may be impossible to distinguish. So it can be they can be exactly the same, and in this case, the operator won't be able to identify this traffic. So finally, there are test call generation platforms that can be used to measure and detect OTT bypass. These are commercial platforms. They are used a lot by operators to do a lot of different quality of service testing. They are easy to deploy. They don't interfere with the real user traffic, so there are no privacy ethical concerns. But they don't give the real, give a representative measurement of the real volume of bypass on the network. Still, we use the test calls in our case study because it was like the most obvious way, and it was the best way to see the effects of OTT bypass. So we also analyzed in the paper the disadvantages and advantages of all these different techniques, and we see that there is no perfect solution to completely detect and measure OTT bypass. We make a case study on a mobile operator in a small European country. In this case study, we first make two different test call campaigns. One of them is via a commercial test call generation platform, and one of them via our own test call generation platform that we created. During this test, we had four SIM cards from the victim operator. Three of them was registered to the OTT network with different configurations, connectivity configurations, and one of them was never registered on the OTT network, just for comparison reasons. In the first test call campaign, we made more than 1,000 test calls from 50 countries and 148 operators. We observed bypass from 90% of the originating countries and 62% of the networks. And so this shows that the prevalence of OTT bypass was very high to this destination. We also check if the bypass rates depend on the recipient location or the type of the originating number. So in this case, the recipient location, whether the recipient is roaming in another network or if he is in his domestic network, doesn't make any difference on the rate, on the bypass rate. And we also saw that the landline numbers, fixed numbers, are bypassed as well as the mobile numbers. So in the second test call campaign, we wanted to create a more flexible platform that we can have more control on it and we can collect better data. So for this, we use customized Android phones, both in the originating origination end, also in the recipient end. We have the recipient phones roaming in France, just because we are in France. And we have the originating phones in 8 different European countries. So in this case, we can only test one operator per country, but all of the operators we test, they were major telecom operators. We collect the logs from the caller, the callee phones, and also from the victim operator. We make more than 15,000 test calls during the campaign. So to summarize the result, we have detected OTT bypass from 6 of the 8 countries. The bypass rates were changing between 42% and 83%. The most problematic country was Spain in this case. We also showed that OTT bypass leads to several quality problems in the call establishment. I will give an example of this later. And we showed that multiple different fraud schemes may actually collide. So we observe the effects of other fraud schemes in addition to the OTT bypass. So one example of this was the collision of SIMBox bypass and OTT bypass. So when you have a SIMBox in the call route, typically the caller ID information will be changed because you get the call from the IP network and then you re-inject it to the telephone network via the SIM card, and so your caller ID information will be the caller ID of the SIM card. So during our tests, we observed a lot of caller IDs belonging to a Russian mobile operator. Basically, so we have different phones. One of them is not registered to the OTT network, and one of them is registered to the OTT. And for the phone that is not registered to the OTT, we had 60% of SIMBox bypass, which means 60% of the calls were coming with SIMBAX caller IDs. And for the phone that was online on the OTT network, we had 15% of the calls arriving normally, but with SIMBAX caller ID. Of course, there was also OTT bypass. We had 35% of OTT bypass. And also, we saw some calls coming over the OTT network, but with SIMBAX caller IDs, which means that there was actually another OTT gateway after the after the fraudulent operator that is performing the SIMBAX. So when you combine all of these different fraud, you actually get almost 80% of your traffic being subject to OTT bypass. And also another result consequence of this is, for example, you have a friend calling you from UK from your mobile phone, and you get the call on your OTT application with a Russian caller ID, which is really confusing. So we also measure to be able to see the effect of OTT bypass on call establishment. We wanted to measure the post-dial delay. It is a very common quality metric for operators. What is a post-dial delay? It is basically when you start the call, you just press the call button, and then you will have the call signaling process happening. The call is established, and at some point the recipient will be notified about the call, and finally you will get a response about your call. And when you get the response, you will either hear a ringtone or a busy signal or unreachable message, etc. PDD is a very important metric because it basically affects the caller's decision to abandon the call or not. It directly relates to user experience. So this is a normal call, and we have a PSTN switch. But in case of OTT bypass, there will be a PSTN to OTT gateway, which will increase the amount of which will make the call establishment more complicated. So we were expecting that the PSTN to OTT gateway will increase the PDD value. However, our experiments show that the PDD values for normal and bypassed calls were almost the same. So we wanted to measure another metric, which is the ring time difference, which is the time difference between a recipient's phone ringing and the caller getting the ring back signal. And in this case, we actually saw that recipient phone starts recipient's phone ringing with a few seconds of delay, even for the normal calls. But for the OTT bypass calls, this delay was much higher. So when the call is bypassed, there were on average 50 seconds of difference after the caller hears the ringing tone. So caller starts hearing the ringtone, and during the 50 seconds, the callee will not be notified at all, which affects the caller's decision to continue the call or not. So this shows that actually OTT bypass affects the quality of call establishment, but this effect is concealed by the operator or the OTT provider. So we very quickly, I will pass. So we also make a user study. We have more than 7,000 participants. We first measured the awareness on the OTT bypass. 38% of people said that they were previously aware of the OTT bypass option, and 12% said that they have already disabled this option on their application. We also measured the tendency to disable this OTT bypass after learning the effects, and 45% said that they will consider opting out after they learned about OTT bypass. So in conclusion, OTT bypass may have severe consequences, both for operators and for the users. It is very challenging to detect and measure. In particular, you need to distinguish between the normal OTT and the OTT bypass, because otherwise you may violate network neutrality. And it is very important to increase the awareness of this topic to be able to find a good solution. Thanks. If you have any questions.
We have time for two quick questions.
Hey, I'm Jan Shartashvili from UC Santa Barbara. This is super fascinating. Not an area of security I usually deal with. But I have one quick question. You mentioned that you might have a call that you're calling into the UK and it gets hijacked, goes to the SIM box, ends up coming from a Russian number.
Yeah.
Wouldn't it be more financially beneficial for them to bring it through a UK number? Because then it's a local call for them. Because from a Russian SIM box, wouldn't be an international call, and then they would...
Exactly. So this all depends on the arbitrage opportunity on the network. So if currently there is a Russian operator which is advertising very low rates to our victim country, then they basically use the SIM cards from that operator. But it could have been another country as well, or it could be another operator in the victim country itself, which in this case it will be a local call, as you said.
Awesome, thank you.
So Marco from Trend Micro. I have two quick questions. One is just me not understanding. So when you have basically this OTT bypass, so how can the operator know which kind of OTT application you have installed on your mobile, if it's like WhatsApp or Skype or, I don't know, or Viber?
The operator doesn't know. So the OTT provider goes directly to an operator and makes an agreement saying that if you want to terminate your calls over my network, this will be the price. And this price usually is cheaper than another route. So the bypassing operator makes an agreement with the OTT providers. And if the destination is registered on the OTT network, then the call is hijacked. But the operator doesn't really know which application is installed on the user's phone. Okay.
And the other question I have, you show an experiment that you try to measure which country is more like affected by this problem, and it seems like Spain is one of the top. So in that case, did you buy like SIM card related to different countries, or did you ask somebody in that country to make a call on your number, or made the SIM card sent to France and then you were in roaming?
Yeah, exactly. We were roaming, but when you roam in another country as the originating party, you basically use the
provider of
that operator, so it doesn't make any difference.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.